Hi everyone, welcome to Grade Up. My name is Deepthi Mittal. In this video lecture, we are going to study digital logic. So guys, if you are from engineering background, you must have heard about digital logic because it is a common subject for so many branches. It is taught in computer science, electrical engineering, electronics, information technology. So this is quite a common subject for so many branches. In this particular video lecture, we will study what actually DLD is. We will study the basic things required for DLD. Second thing, we are going to find out the weightage analysis for DLD in our gate examination for CSE. Third thing which we are going to discuss is book, which you can refer while studying. And fourth thing, how we are going to study this particular subject, the complete subject. That is how we are going to divide this particular subject in our video lectures. So let us start with DLD. First of all, the first thing which we are going to discuss is weightage analysis of DLD in our gate examination. So let us start the weightage analysis. So guys, if I talk about the recent examination, that is the exam this year, that is GATE 2018, this DLD was asked for 4 marks. In last year examination, that is GATE 2017, in paper 1 it was asked for 4 marks and in paper 2 it was asked for 10 marks, around 10 marks. You can see this 10 marks is a huge. In 2016, in both paper 1 and paper 2, it was asked for 3 marks. In GATE 2015, in paper 1 and paper 2, it was asked for 5 marks and in paper 3, it was asked for 7 marks. And in GATE 2014, it was asked for 2 marks in both paper 1 and paper 2 and in paper 3, it was asked for 3 marks. So, I have taken last 5-year analysis to check what is the weightage of DLD in our GATE examination. So, if I find out the average, I can say that DLD is asked for around 5 marks every year. So, you can see these 5 marks can be the game changer in your GATE examination. Guys, I have seen that people think like DLD is not that important subject and it is not asked for that much marks and we can skip this particular subject. Yes, this is true that it is not asked for that much marks every year, but you can observe in GATE 2017 it was asked for 10 marks. Yes, it is true that it is not asked for so much marks, but these marks are really, really important for you for getting a good rank, because this particular subject, this is the subject from where scoring is so easy, and you should not skip such type of subjects from where scoring is easy. I can say that weightage is quite less, but this scoring is quite easy. So you should strategize, like you should get these 4 marks, that you should not allow, you should plan in such a way that not even 1 marks can be deducted. My strategy was to score such marks which is easy to score, so I prepared those subjects from where scoring is very easy, very well, because DLD is quite an easy subject. Just study it one time and you will be clear with all the concepts. So guys, let us start with DLD, what actually DLD is.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update from GradeUp.
Before starting with DLD, let us mention the standard book which you can refer while you are studying. Suppose you are studying and you get some doubt, then you can refer this book, Digital Logic and Computer Design by Maurice Mano. This book is really good for digital logic and it contains a lot of questions on each and every topic. And it can help you while your practice. And language is quite easy. I'm not saying that you should study this whole book, because if you are going to study this whole book, you can study, but it will take a lot of time. So you can refer it for your doubts and for practicing the questions. This is a standard book for our digital logic. One more suggestion for studying, you should always refer only the standard books. Try to avoid studying from local books, because in standard books, whatever data is there, it is authenticated. You will always get the correct data. So just try to refer the standard books. Let us start with DLD. So DLD stands for Digital Logic Design. What can I say Digital Logic Design? See, talk in simple words. You know computer. Computer can be categorized into two things, hardware and software. Software is something where we deals with programming languages, and hardware where we deals with designing. So DLD is that particular branch or that particular field which deals with the hardware design of our computer. Then what we are going to do in our DLD? Yes, we are going to design the hardware. We are going to design the logic systems. And how we are going to design these particular system? Using logic gates and the properties, or the logic gates and the combinational circuits which we derive using logic gates. So what can I say about DLD? DLD is that particular field of our computer science which deals with the hardware design for functioning of the computer. Okay, let us move towards next thing. This is the basic for our DLD. What you can say? Boolean algebra. Our logic gates or DLD deals with Boolean algebra. As we know, our mathematics deals with algebra. There we deal with decimal number system. But in our logic gates or DLD, we deals with Boolean algebra. Like in our decimal number system, we have number from 0 to 9. In Boolean algebra, we have binary number system, which deals with discretes 0 and 1. The number you are going to have is 0 and 1. And the output set is also 0 and 1, which is true or false. That is, you are going to give some inputs in the form of 0 and 1, and you will get output also in the form of 0 and 1. As you know, in our number systems or in our languages, we used to represent variables. Variables are used to hold some particular data. Here, these are the Boolean variables. These are Boolean variables, then they are going to hold data which is Boolean, that is either 0 or either 1. If a particular variable is going to hold 0 or 1, then it is known as Boolean variables. Boolean variables can be represented by capital letter or small letter. See, if you have to represent 0, this 0 is represented directly. Suppose you have to represent 1, sorry, this 0 will be represented in complemented form. This is the complemented form of a variable. If you represent a variable with comma or bar, then it is known as complemented form. And 1 is represented directly. It is uncomplemented form. So for 0, if value of a is 0, you are going to represent it in complemented form. If value of a is 1, you are going to represent it directly. See, these are the literals a bar, b bar, a and b. Literals are different from variable. For variables, a bar and a is same because they both are a. But for literals, a bar and a are different. Let us move towards next thing, which is logic gates. Guys, I told you that we are going to design our hardware system. And how we are going to design it? We are going to design it using logic gates. And I am sure that you have studied about logic gates in your 12th standard. You are having a good idea about logic gates. So, we will get an overview of all the logic gates which are present in our DLD system. Basically, there are three basic logic gates, which are OR, AND, and NOT. And all the remaining XOR, XNOR, NAND, NOR are derived using these basic logic gates. So, these are basic logic gates, or these are known as derived logic gates. So, let us see the functioning of each and every gate. I think you are aware of it. We will take a quick look or quick overview over the logic gates. See, this is OR gate. For OR gate, you can use plus, union or V symbol, and it is the logic gate symbol for our OR gate. How you are going to represent its equation? Y is equals to A plus V. It is the truth table. You know what is a truth table? Yes. Truth table is all the is the table consisting of all the possible combinations which can be provided as input. See, for this A and B, if A and B are the inputs and Y is the output for my OR gate, all the possible combinations I have written, both can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, This is known as truth table. So this particular OR gate is going to give output as 1 if at least one of the input is 1. If any one of the input is 1, you will get output as 1, otherwise 0. Also, this OR gate is a binary operator. That is, you should give at least 2 inputs. You can give more than 2, but you should give at least 2 inputs. That was all about OR gate. Let us move towards AND gate. See, AND gate is represented by dot. You are going to give 2 inputs and you will get Y is equals to A dot B as the output. And this is the logic gate for our AND gate. This AND gate is also a binary operator. That is, you have to give at least 2 operands for performing the operation. And where AND gate will result you 1 when both the inputs are 1. See, it will result 1 only if both the inputs are 1. Otherwise, it is going to give 0. If you are going to take AND gate with 3 inputs, then all the 3 inputs should be 1. It results only 1 if all the inputs are 1. This is the property of AND gate. Let us move towards next basic gate, which is NOT gate. See, this is the NOT gate. This is some buffer and this symbol represent NOT of this buffer. What this NOT gate is going to do, whatever input you are going to provide, it will just complement it. Complement is just reverting. 0 will be converted to 1 and 1 will be converted to 0. It is represented by comma or bar. Also, this is the representation. See, now next gate is XOR gate. This XOR gate is the derived gate which we derive using our basic logic gates, which were OR gate, AND gate and NOT gate. So this is XOR symbol and this is the logic gate symbol for our XOR gate. What is the property of XOR gate? XOR gate says it will give you output as 1 if odd number of inputs are 1. See the truth table, both are 0, it will produce 0. In 2 inputs, only 1 is 1, then it will produce 1. A is 1, B is 0, again 1. Both are 1, it is going to produce output as 0. Result of XOR operator is 1 if odd number of inputs are 1. If you are going to write the equation, it is written as A bar B plus A B bar. This is about XOR gate. XOR gate is also known as inequality checking gate. Because it is going to give output as 1 only when odd number of inputs are 1. See, both A and B are not equal, then it is giving me output as 1. They are not equal, then it is giving me output as 1. Let us move towards next gate, which is XNOR gate. XNOR gate is represented by this symbol and the logic gate of XNOR gate is this. XNOR and XOR are complement of each other. That is, whatever result you obtain from your XOR gate, just complement it, apply NOT gate over it and you will get your result of XNOR gate. It is also a binary operator associated with 2 operands. Okay, you can see this is obtained by applying NOT operator over XOR gate. So, if you remember the truth table of my XOR gate, it was 0, 1, 1, 0. But it is just revert of that particular truth table 1001. It is going to give you output as 1 when both the inputs are equal. See, when you are giving 00, it is giving 1111. Or another name for XNOR gate is equality checking gate. Because it gives output as 1 when both the inputs are 1. Let us move towards next gate, which is NAND gate. It is also one of the derived gate. We are deriving this gate using our basic gate. It is represented by an upward arrow. And how you are going to derive this gate? AND followed by NOT. That is, you will apply an AND gate, then apply the NOT operation over that AND gate. According to AND gate, what will you get as output? AB. Then again, applying NOT operation over AND gate. And then you will get your NAND gate as the output. It is also a binary operator, that is, you have to give at least 2 operands for performing the operation. And see, in our AND gate, we are getting result as 1 only if all the inputs are 1. But here in NAND gate, you will get output as 1 if any one of the input is 0. See the combination, if 0, 0, if at least one of the input is 0, then we are going to get output as 1, otherwise 0. This is the property of NAND gate. Let us move towards next gate, which is NOR gate. It is represented by a downward arrow. NOR gate, as name suggests, OR followed by NOT. It is derived by using two basic logic gates, which were OR gate, and then again it is followed by NOT. So for OR gate, the equation was A plus B, and when you are going to perform NOT of it, you will get NOR gate. NOR gate, if you remember the case of OR gate, you were getting output as 1 if any one of the input is 1. But in this case, you will get output as 1 if all the variables are 0. If both the inputs are 0, see, 0 plus 0, 0 plus 0 will be 0, and 0 complement will be 1. That is, it is going to give you output as 1 only if all the inputs are 0. It is also a binary operator. You should give at least two operands for its functioning. These are all about some our logic gates. So, we have studied three basic gates, AND, OR, NOT, and then we derived four other logic gates. So guys, this was all about our logic gates in our digital logic system. Let us see the topics which we are going to cover in upcoming videos for coverage of our full syllabus. I have divided my syllabus or DLD into three parts: Boolean algebra, combinational circuit, and sequential circuit. In Boolean algebra, in this particular video, I have mentioned all the logic gates. In our next video, firstly, we will discuss properties on logic gates, then canonical forms for writing the expression. Then we will see what the number system is and how to represent numbers in different bases. Then next thing, we are going to write K-maps and minimal expressions for the realized expressions and realized functions. Then we will see what a PI, EPI, cyclic K-map is. In Boolean algebra, we will cover all these topics. Then after studying Boolean algebra, that is basic for our digital logic design, we will move towards next topic, which is combinational circuit. You know, combinational circuits are obtained by combining one or two logic gates. So we will study their code converters. These combinational circuits will be used for realizing the real life examples or the functions. So in this particular combinational circuit topic, we will discuss the functioning of so many things. We will discuss adder subtractors, BCD adders, binary comparator circuits, multiplexers, demultiplexers, decoders, encoder, priority encoder, and all these type of combinational circuit which are part of our digital system, we will discuss in combinational circuit. After studying combinational circuit, we will move towards sequential circuit. Sequential circuits are different from combinational circuit, as output is dependent on the current state output in our sequential circuits. Here we will study the basics and flip-flops, then how to convert a flip-flop into another. Then we will study the most important topic in our digital logic design, which is counter. Both the types of counters will be discussed: synchronous counters, asynchronous counter, ring counter, Johnson counter, register. We are going to discuss each and everything. So this is the plan how we are going to cover our syllabus for digital logic design. Guys, this was the introductory video for our digital logic design. I have discussed why we are studying digital logic design. Guys, one more thing. I always follow the strategy, like whenever I study a particular topic or a particular subject, I always used to find out why I am studying this. What is the need of studying this particular topic? You should follow the same strategy, because once you find out the reason behind studying of that particular topic, your motivation, your interest for studying that subject increases, and that motivation leads to positive result. One more thing which I want to say you, that practice is the key for your success. Whenever I complete one topic, just try to solve two, three previous year question on that particular topic, so that you can get the clarity and you can clearly know whether you are able to solve these questions and what are the extra efforts which are required for solving this question. Is it required to refer some book, something? For knowing all these things, whether you are accurate, whether you are getting the topic or not, you should first practice. So my suggestion is practice a good number of questions on each and every topic. One thing, believe in yourself. always believe in yourself that you can do a particular thing. If you are targeting for GATE, just believe in yourself that you can crack this exam. There is nothing great about GATE. So many people every year appear for this exam and they get the thing which they need, PSUs, IITs, everything. And so, what is the reason you cannot get that? You can get. You can easily get each and everything which you want in your life. The thing which is required is just your positive attitude and positive efforts. So, never lose positive attitude and positive efforts in your life. Guys, thank you for watching this video. In our next video lecture, we will start with Boolean algebra. Thank you again.